Hey, hey, Pisces, intuitive soul coach here with your December 2024 love reading. Welcome back to my channel if you're returning, and welcome if you're new. If you're interested in a personal reading, signing up for the monthly newsletter, or entering into the free reading giveaway, you can find all of that information in the description box below the video. All right, Pisces, bottom of the deck, you have the picture card, and I'm hearing the song by Kid Rock and Sheryl Crow, Picture. So there may be a relationship or a situation of the past that you feel a bit nostalgic over. Even if this is physically over, you still at times may dream of this person, or they may still creep up in your mind at times. For those of you that are still in this dynamic, I feel like you've gone through a lot, okay? You've gone through a lot with the nostalgia card. Someone could even be thinking about you as you rise above. So today we'll look at what you're thinking, feeling, and actioning, and the person on your mind. This could be a lover, it could be a friend, it could be a family member, or it could be someone incoming. So please take it as it resonates. Now, you could be missing someone, or they could be missing you, but I feel like you're making new memories. Maybe there's someone of the past that's moved on and they're making new memories, but they're still showing up in your energy for some reason. So we'll take a look here at what's truly going on. Now, your first card out is the Phoenix. Pisces, this is a new phase. Now, some of you, because we have the picture with nostalgia here, you could be rekindling an energy that you are currently in, but maybe that flame has died out, or it could be someone from the past. Now, you have grown a lot, and some of you may even change your mind. You may have thought someone was your forever, but you may be thinking otherwise. This is about rising from the ashes, and I feel like you're doing you. I really feel like you've been focusing on your growth. You've been focusing on your health and focusing possibly on your abundance. And I do feel like you're making a comeback and you're entering into the next phase of a relationship dynamic, either the relationship with another individual or potentially your relationship with your higher self. Now, you have the poker face and the shock factor here. So this is kind of like the tower. And I think it was Gemini and maybe Leo. There was a couple other signs that received the poker face. And someone may have been holding back their feelings, okay? But I feel like the shock, you may have been shocked when someone told you how they felt, or perhaps there was a sudden change, there is shocking news coming in. This could be a surprise or an epiphany or a major transformation. But I feel like you are not showing your hand just yet. So perhaps through some sort of change, you're entering in the new phase, but you're not letting a lot of people know, right? You're holding back. But I feel December could be the month where you take a chance, you take a risk. And I see here that you're throwing out the dice, you're gambling here on something, or perhaps someone that you have dealt with, maybe they took a chance and it shocked you. So let's dive in. What is going on in your thoughts? What are you thinking at this time, Pisces, in matters of the heart in a relationship? The throat chakra. So this is about communication. You're thinking about how to communicate potentially with someone. And it's interesting because right behind the picture, you actually have the love called. So this is about messages of love, thinking of you, maybe even informing you, or you're informing someone. You want to connect, you want to talk, you want to communicate, but you've been holding back possibly ever since a shock had happened. I almost feel like this has already happened for you because you're on to the next phase. You're on to the rekindling, the renewal, but I feel like you're preparing. You don't want to just put something out there without thinking about it, and you could actually shock others is what I'm getting. So maybe you've changed your mind and you have some news that could really shock others at this time. Let's see what else is going on here. All right, you have the Five of Pentacles. You want to connect. You want to come back to a place of feeling supported. The Five of Pentacles can be feeling left out in the cold. But the good news is I feel like you're seeing that there's a light on in the house. You're seeing here that there is hope emerging. Because when this Five of Pentacles shows up, I feel like some of you were really going through some deep changes, possibly around the home or around your health even, or the body. And now you want to speak up because there was a situation that shocked you and you felt very alone. And I feel like you're going to speak up now and share your story or talk to someone and let them know how they made you feel. There could be something here about an honest conversation, needing to come clean, needing to take a risk and tell someone something. I feel like this is the only thing that is going to help you push through, is what I'm getting with this Five of Pentacles. Someone's pride or arrogance got in the way of a relationship. All right, let's take a look at how you're feeling. How are you feeling? Yeah, which caused you to potentially move on. You have the Eight of Cups here, caused you to move on and cut ties. And I see with this Eight of Cups, there's a lot of personal growth from whatever that shock factor was. You had to discover bits and parts of yourself all over again. And that's what I'm getting here with this Five of Pentacles, right? You have to discover who you are and come back home to a place deep within yourself and connect with your body. A lot of you are connecting with your body, and this could even be through dance, through singing, through expression with that throat chakra. It almost feels like someone was tongue-tied. They didn't even know what to say. Maybe someone didn't say anything for quite some time. Okay, maybe there's been a blockage of communication here. And I feel like she's looking at the home. And even though the moon is in the background and there is a level of uncertainty, I feel like she's contemplating what she's going to say, even though what she has to say, another person might not like what they hear. Or maybe she doesn't like what she hears when she gets to that place, but I feel like this is pivotal. There's a pivotal marker, mile marker, that is coming up between you and another. And I see that, yes, you moved on here with the Eight of Cups. You're feeling like you want something deeper, something more meaningful. And you are listening to your intuition when your intuition said, Pisces, it's time for a new path ahead. But you felt disconnected for a while, because there was an attachment, right? You were, I don't want to say forced, but because that shock factor is here, it's like you were forced to leave something or someone behind in order to grow. And even though it hurt, you knew that something better was waiting. Even though you didn't know what, you had to trust. Now, how are you actioning this up? The Two of Cups in reverse. So the Two of Cups is showing up here as possibly rejecting the status quo, rejecting an offer. We'll take a look at the person on your mind, what they're thinking, feeling, and how they are coming towards you. Now, perhaps you are wanting to look back here or look at this home front and speak up so things don't feel as challenging or as heavy. It's like you want to enter into the new phase. Because right now you're feeling very separate. You're feeling very disconnected from someone. Maybe you do want to come together, but again, pride or ego or a battle of, you know, pain or hurt got in the way of feeling safe, of feeling stable. So let's look at the person on your mind. What are they thinking? What are they feeling, and how are they going to action it up? Because right now I just feel like there is a bit of separation, but you're contemplating what you need to say or how you need to, you know, logically move forward to come back to a place of feeling at home, feeling safe, feeling good about where you stand. All right, what's this person thinking? High Priestess, it's in reverse though. This person may have held back. They may have had a lot of secrets. They may have struggled listening to you, Pisces. They may not have been a good listener. When the High Priestess is showing up in reverse, she could even have a hidden agenda. Withholding, right? Maybe they withheld information or they detached themselves in some way. And I feel like their intuition was guiding them to go in one direction, but they weren't listening to it. And I feel like you were trying to get through to them, but no matter what, it's like you weren't able to get through because they weren't able to listen. They didn't want to listen, and that was their choice. So maybe this person, logically, it feels like there was a little bit of miscommunication here, and it caused them to detach. All right. What are they feeling? What are they feeling towards Pisces? And of course, roles can be reversed, so please take it as it resonates. We have here the Seven of Swords. Now, Pisces, I will tell you, you're the last sign for love readings, and they are heavy. They're heavy this month, and I feel like it is the Pluto and Aquarius transit where things are shaking up to prepare us for the next 19 years, right? To prepare us for the types of relationships that we really deserve, that we really want to be in. And it has us looking at some things that are working in our existing relationships and things that are not. And are we willing to accept them where they're at? Can we work through them? Do we want to stay patient while we have hopes that people's potentials are going to shine through? But what I'm seeing is with this Aquarian energy, things are manifesting quite quickly. So this person, how they're feeling is they want to be honest, but they struggle with it. They struggle with honesty because they hold things back. They may not have that emotional intelligence to be able to fully express how they feel, or perhaps there's been lying, cheating, manipulation. There's been a little bit of instant gratification. This person may want what they want and they don't deal with the consequences until later, right? They don't apologize till after the fact is what I'm seeing here. And it feels like this person struggles listening to their intuition and it lands them in some hot water. Okay, this person may also cover up some of their wounds is what I'm getting. Yeah, they may cover up some of their wounds through trying to sugarcoat, trying to put on a facade, or they wear a mask in some way. Maybe they cover it up with addiction, or they cover it up with, you know, the poker face even. They don't show their hand. They don't really take risks. Or if they do roll the dice and gamble, it's not on the right things. So I feel like this person is struggling here with their feelings because the Seven of Swords can be someone who is living in an illusion and they don't know how to quite trust their intuition with that High Priestess in reverse. So what's the action? What is the action that this person is taking when it comes to Pisces or when it comes to love? All right. They want to take the lead. They want to be a better version. This person could be a workaholic. They may be dominant. They may be controlling at times or very, very much in their masculine. And the Emperor is showing up here in the upright, but I feel like they struggle. Sometimes they struggle to be the Emperor in the upright. Sometimes they struggle with authority or they struggle with their own stability, which is not the case of the Emperor in the upright. But because we have these two challenges here, we have the High Priestess, it's like this person's physical self, right? Or the egoic self gets in the way of the emotional well-being. And it's like this person would much rather have things their way than trusting that maybe the universe has a better plan for them. So what does that mean for you? It means that it's going to cause a ripple in this union. It means that this person's maybe ego causes you to feel a little bit isolated, causes you to feel left out. This person may take care of a lot of other things or other people. Maybe they're a business owner, they work too much, or they can't give you everything you need because they're too busy focusing on other things. The Emperor has a lot going on. They could be a father, they could be a business owner, they could be someone that, you know, a lot of people rely on, or it could even be, because I'm getting hints of the reversal, sometimes this person could have traits of narcissism, right? Or traits of greed or control, right? I just feel like this person likes to have things in the way they like to have them, and it causes conflict. Look at this. We have double fives. I'm just recognizing this here with the throat chakra and the five of pentacles. This person could also be greedy and greedy with their time, where their time is reserved for the physicality or the physical things, other people. And it feels like this person puts everything else or everybody else ahead of you. And you're like, wait a second, shouldn't our relationship be a priority? So let's get the advice. What's the advice here? Okay, we just need one. What's the advice? Okay, we're going to go with all of them. The advice here is the Ace of Pentacles. I do feel like you want a fresh start. Someone wants a fresh start. Whether it's with this individual or not, this is the start of a new life. The Ace of Pentacles is strengthening a bond. And I feel right now, because I see this Two of Cups, it feels like you're not as strong as you've been before or as strong as you could be. Because again, there's some sort of shock coming in, if it hasn't already. And I see that someone does want a new beginning. Someone wants their physical health and well-being to match up. They want their spiritual well-being. Someone could have even struggled financially as well, or with a job setting. And maybe a job, the pressure of a job really kind of put pressure on this relationship. But maybe that is what's shifting here in order to have a new beginning. Now we have the Lover showing up as the action. What would love do? Now, we do see two people coming together here, but I do see that someone feels like there is a choice to make, because this can be the choice card. So either you are in a situation, potentially Gemini energy, Aries energy here, where you want to come together because there's love between you and this person. But love goes above and beyond when it's showing up in the Lovers. This is what would love do? And sometimes love is setting something free, if that's what needs to happen in order for both individuals to grow and be happy. So what I see happening here for you, the action is asking yourself, am I loved? Am I committed to this love union? Is this something that I can see that I'm growing and having a fresh start with my best friends? Or is this a situation that I'm going to accept and we're going to be going round and round, right? Because I almost feel like these two kind of go round and round. You know that game where you hold the hands? Remember on Titanic when they're down in the bottom part of the boat and they're dancing and they grab each other's hands and going round and round? Some of you could be feeling like you're about ready to let go. Right? Feeling like you're about ready to let go. But I feel when it comes to making this choice, you're really going to tune into your heart. And you're going to say, what is self-love here for me? And what is love between us both? Do we have what it takes to have this new beginning? Do we have what it takes to enter into a new phase? Now, for those of you, if this is a brand new person here, this person could have dealt with hidden agendas. They could have dealt with lying or cheating in the past. Maybe they've gone through some manipulation here, but they're still showing up as the Emperor in the upright. So I feel like there is a contract here, and this contract is to teach you, because the Emperor, he is a solid teacher. He teaches you. Sometimes it's challenges. Sometimes it's lessons, right? But he definitely teaches you one way or the other. And your outcome is the third eye chakra. What are you envisioning? Can you see yourself with this person 5 years down the road, 10 years down the road? You know, if things did not change, if you're in this dynamic with someone right now and things did not change, although they're going to because things always change, but can you accept it for where it's at now? Or do both of you love each other enough to put in the work? Because relationships are work, but also it should be your best friend. This should be someone that you want to grow old with, someone that you feel safe with, someone that you don't have to feel like you are left out in the cold or out in the blue. And that's kind of what I see here. And look at that. The throat chakra is blue. So it's like you feel blue over a situation, or maybe you hear from this person out of the blue. You've been doing your thing. Maybe you've been working on your health and your wealth and your abundance. And then all of a sudden, this person comes back in and you're like, whoa, wait a second. This is a shock. I haven't heard from you in a long time. And they're now in a different position. Maybe they have changed because we all change. Now, some of you, that may rub you the wrong way because you've seen evidence of the other, right? You've seen evidence of people not changing, not growing, not maturing. And yes, people tend to kind of cycle out, but they change when they're ready to. But we're constantly evolving, even if we don't always see it in another individual, because remember, that's what we come down to planet Earth to do. So change is inevitable. It is part of the process. Now, it could be change that occurs with other people. Maybe someone that you were with didn't change while they were with you, but they could have changed for someone else. But ultimately, it's their choice, their decision. So I feel like there's some offer coming in here, and you have a choice to make, right? Do I love this person? Do I want to open up my heart to them after feeling left out or feeling like I had to cut ties? Because the Two of Cups is here. So I feel like you have a lot of love. You absolutely do, Pisces. You have a lot of love. And right behind the love call, we actually have the wedding rings. So this could be a situation where you're married to someone. Perhaps if you were with them in the past, you had a high level commitment. Maybe you lived together or you were engaged. Or this could be the potential for this down the road. But with your outcome being the third eye chakra, which I'm going to pull one more card here, it's important for you to keep that open and trust in the bigger picture. Trust in the bigger vision, but make choices based on, yes, logic, but know that that logic can shift if people show you through their actions. Not just their talking the talk, but they're walking the walk and staying consistent with it. All right, what do we have here? You're getting a lot of clumps of energy. So it almost feels like some things may all come in at once instead of maybe independently. It feels like I'm getting a whole bunch of information here, and then it kind of trails, and then a whole bunch of information here. So a lot of drops, a lot of downloads. All right, wow. You have the Five of Swords, the Seven of Cups, and the Eight of Pentacles. No wonder this is such a difficult situation for you, because you've gone through the Five of Swords. Maybe someone taking advantage, someone that's been very angry, poor sportsmanship, bullying, manipulation, deceit, you know, all the things that we do not love to be in with this Five of Swords. It's a very challenging energy. It's a battle of the egos. It's victory through dominance or control that come at a cost. And that can be that Aries energy coming in. And I feel like it was, you know, it was a lose-lose, even though it may feel like someone won. Typically, it's a lose-lose when we see this Five of Swords. And I feel like the win-win is walking away, right? Or the win can be choosing our battles, when to fight for something, when to walk away from it. And in the past, you may have chose one option, but there's something new being shown to you this time around. You have a new option, okay? Because the Seven of Cups can be another choice. This can be exploring your possibilities, but it's going to require you to ground yourself. It's going to require you to set aside any ego-driven judgments, okay? Because that can bring about illusions. That can cloud our choices. And I feel like there's a new path here for you to take. And I see someone wants to put in some dedicated effort. Eight of Pentacles is putting in the work. So someone wants to put in the work, and maybe that shocks you, or maybe you are putting in the work towards, you know, other options at this time because you've chose to walk away from this union. Take it as it resonates. But whatever choice you make, you're the Phoenix, Pisces. You're entering into a new phase and you're rekindling something within yourself. Whether that is, again, your connection with the divine, whether it's your connection with an individual, or you're coming out of some sort of aha moment, and you're going to make a choice that's in your highest good. Even if it requires you putting in the work to move forward in your life, you're going to do what it takes. All right, let's get a message from the wisdom of the oracle. What do we have here for Pisces, please? Wisdom of the oracle and matters of the heart. You have the tribe. And this does remind me again of the Five of Pentacles. It's like you just want to find your people. You see that she's looking back at that home front, and maybe everyone has abandoned her. Perhaps it feels like she's been left all alone. Card 8, which is also the Emperor. Or excuse me, the strength. The tribe is community, belonging, being seen and understood by others, like-minded connections, a sense of family and friendship, as well as knowing your place in the world. You are discovering the essential qualities that you share with another, and perhaps also those that you don't share. There are times when you follow and the other person leads, and there are times when you lead and the other person follows. The appearance of this card points to the importance of learning the proper dance between you and another. Accepting the truth that everyone has flaws is part of that dance. Yet you are also being asked to be aware of the dynamics that you don't want to repeat. You are in the perfect place to make changes in order to experience the best version of who you can be together. This is absolutely, and that coincides with the entirety of your reading, because sometimes this person likes to take the lead, maybe a lot more than letting you take the lead at times. And that's frustrating because you don't feel heard or seen, and that causes a little bit of a disconnect here. Now, the protection message is this, and this is for those of you that are contemplating maybe exiting, okay, or contemplating cutting ties or moving on. Beware of compromising your integrity in order to belong. How do you dim your light or change yourself so others will accept you in the tribe? Do you hide who you really are in order to play a role within the larger role? This will never fulfill you. Now is a time to assess your willingness to be real. Stand tall. Be you. Authenticity is true expression, self-expression, there's that throat chakra, and the only way to empower yourself. Don't be afraid to be yourself and step into the role your heart tells you to take. There's the heart energy here with the Lovers. There's the new role, okay, with the Ace of Pentacles. Making yourself small, Pisces, bears too high of a cost. So either you step up, right? Step up to being authentically you and saying, if we're doing this, it's a dance, right? Sometimes you lead, sometimes I follow, sometimes I lead, sometimes you follow, but it's not one-sided, because that one-sided crap is going to push me so far away that I don't know that rubber band is going to snap at some point. And maybe it hasn't yet, maybe it has, but I do feel like you're third eye chakra is giving you insight, is definitely giving you insight into what to do at this time. Meditate, right? Meditate on this. Try not to make a rash, impulsive decision, because the Ace of Pentacles isn't to be rushed, but I also feel it's important to trust yourself and your intuition. Let's get a message here from your crystal spirits. And at this time, Pisces, if you can safely do so, please close your eyes. Take a nice deep breath in from your solar plexus chakra, your belly area. Nice big inhale. Hold it as long as you can. And release through the mouth with a nice deep sigh. And with your eyes still closed, tune into your third eye chakra, the area between your eyebrows and your forehead region. And I want you, Pisces, to imagine the first gemstone or crystal that shows up in your mind's eye. Now your crystal could hold a specific shape. It could be a specific size or color. It could fit in the palm of your hand. Perhaps it is heart-shaped. It could be a beautiful color of blue, orange, red, yellow, green, indigo, violet, or maybe even clear or pink. Your crystal could be polished, tumbled, clustered, or pointed. This could be a piece of jewelry, a ring, or a necklace. You may even know the name of the crystal. And if not, just tune into the frequencies that is emitting, perhaps that of unconditional love, protection, strength, or power. There is no right or wrong answer, Pisces, and if you need a moment, just pause the video and come back when you are ready. And for those of you that would like to be entered into the free monthly reading giveaway, all you need to do is drop your crystal, whether it be the size, the color, the shape, the name, drop it below in the comment section and I personally will enter you into the free reading giveaway. So make sure you hit that subscribe and bell button so you don't miss that notification on the first of the month. All right, we have Amber. Amber is actually, it's not a true crystal, but it's fossilized tree sap, right? And this is about patterns, sometimes passed down by family. When you meditate with Amber Spirit, it's an excellent stone to or fossil to help explore the patterns and shed light on those that no longer serve us. So your relationship message is this. In romantic relationships, we always have a choice to stay or go, to learn and grow, or to move on to a new partnership. If you want to have a different sort of relationship the next time around, Amber Spirit's message to you is clear. Explore your family relationships. Excuse me, that was a big theme for you in the very beginning of your reading. The Five of Pentacles, she's looking at home. She's looking at the home base. She's become very distant from the home. Maybe there's abandonment that's caused separation. There's rejection. There could have been a loved one that crossed over early on. There may have been traumas very early on. And I feel like you are addressing that. You are looking at that now. Explore your family relationships. The nuggets of wisdom that you mine will help you avoid repeating the pain of the past in your partnerships today and in the future. Find these hidden gifts of wisdom and strength so that you may enjoy the loving partnerships that you deserve. Absolutely. So a lot of you are breaking through patterns. And didn't it even say that here? I thought we had breaking patterns on one of your cards. All right. Well, the memories, this could be going back and looking at what's working and what's not. We did mention that. So I feel like there's a new phase. You are growing. You may have changed your mind from something of the past, and that's a good thing sometimes. Now, last but not least, a message from the trees. You have the owl and the tree. It says, don't turn back now. Don't turn back. You are on the right track. because the owl brings you protection. And this is about purpose, spirituality, and your path. And you see that the owl is covering up her heart chakra. So there is a deep inner wisdom that is coming from the heart. And remember, you have the lovers here, Pisces, in the action to take. And I feel like the action here is don't turn back now, right? You are on the right path. Trust in the wisdom of the heart. Beautiful. That is what I have for you, Pisces. If this message resonates, please hit that thumbs up button. Feel free to share, like, subscribe, and do drop your crystals or gemstones or fossils in the comment section below to be entered into that giveaway. And thank you again for tuning in. Lots of love.